Hello, I'm Mr. Nijer, editor, lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. He came in 1469 and threw five more lights. He preached gospel to perfection, leaving no stone unturned. Sikhism is a speciality of Christianity, and total number of years were over 150 years. Still the darkness could not be comprehended. Then our father himself came in the name of Govind Rai, and he sorted them with sword power. Son has no authority to take the life of brethren. So here I'm doing a Gospel of St. Matthew 10:7-13. Jesus said to his apostles, "As you go, make this proclamation: the royal kingdom of God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, and this is the temple of God. God is inside me. If it's clean of cheating, blood money, if I have blood money in my heart, then God is out, Satan is in." So that's why Judas Iscariot, even he was a deceiver, he did not want it to have blood money taken home. So he threw the coins in the temple. He did not want, he wanted God, you know, at the end when he repented, and not mammon. So this is the royal kingdom of God is different from the kingdom of heaven, which is, I put it here. You can see this is rabbinic kingdom of heaven, and this is the royal kingdom of God. It's different. Royal kingdom of God is within your heart, while kingdom of heaven you can see in law and order, which the rabbi, being the ruler, was supposed to do, but they became corrupt. Then Jesus bring in this royal kingdom of God for the individual, inside your own heart. You made the efforts to clean your temple, and royal kingdom of God comes inside here. If your temple is dirty, cheating people, blood money, then Satan is here, God is out. So you can see how the people are killing and other thing in the name of Satan. So, and not of heaven, that belong to Yahweh and his priest rabbis. The royal priest of Elohim is called Christ, or we call him Satguru. And the priest of Yahweh, Prophet Elijah, my God is Yahweh, are rabbis, Brahmins, and so and so, fetish priest. And he was kept alienated. Yahweh, you know, the priest kept the Yahweh alienated from the people. But the royal kingdom of God is at hand inside here, is not kept alienated. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse lepers, drive out demons. Without cost you have received, without cost you are to give. This is very important. Without cost, because these people with the dog collar, they haven't received their degree without cost. They went to university to pay the fees, to live there, and when they come out, like any other profession, like accountancy, chemistry, physics, when they come out, they make money. by charging tithe from the people. But we receive His word by grace of our Father. And we don't pay any money to our Father, and we don't charge money from the people. We receive it free and we give it free. So these people, you know, they made excuses, the laborer is worth his keep. Laborer is paid by God in His currency, which is gospel treasures and not mammon. God doesn't have mammon. So where will He give the mammon to you? Cleanse the labor, drive out demons without cost you have received. Without cost you are to give. This is very important. Rabbi used to go to the school of theology in Jerusalem and pay their teachers who taught them scriptures, the dead letters. When they got qualifications, then they charged their congregation tithe. But we royal priests do not need to go to a university to learn gospel, but by the grace of our Father within our own hearts, we have received gospel and freely we give to fish the spiritual men into the royal kingdom of God. What type of spiritual men are they? That Jesus demonstrated in John 9, born blind person, who was sensible enough to give answer to the rabbis from his own mouth, instead of asking his parents, hey, what shall I say? What should I reply? No, he was solitary, independent solitary. Such are the people who enter into the royal kingdom of God. Those who are blind, they can't find the royal kingdom. Do not take gold or silver or copper for your belts. That means mammon free. That's why people who first joined the Church of God, they sold their possessions and they lived on communal life, community, nobody owning anything. That means they were 100% free of mammon. I remember that Anas and Sapphira, they wanted to join their community. They sold their property and concluded with each other, let's keep some money out of this sale and give the rest to the church. And they came to Peter telling him, this is what we got out of the sale of our property. Peter, being possessed with the very Spirit of God, he knew the matters of their heart. So he asked them twice, you know, is that the sale you have? And then he said, no, we didn't ask you to come and join this community. You are doing it of your own free will. That property which you sold belonged to you. And you did not need to hold back any sale. This is not the total sale. You are not mammon free. You have the tag of mammon left behind. And so for blasphemy comes from the heart, because they colluded with each other. They did the thing knowingly. They were hypocrites, and Peter killed them because he had the power of a kingdom of heaven based upon truth. Truth is the rock over which we build the temple. So they were not truth, they speaking truth, they were liar. John 8 verse 44, where Jesus told these Jewish people that your forefathers are liars and they are devils. So he killed both of them, because he had the key to the kingdom of heaven. None other apostle killed anyone. Their function was different. Peter's function was different. Peter's function was to have the foundation of the temple of God over which people built their temples. That's why whenever there was a new church opening, Peter was the first one to deliver the sermon. Then the apostle will follow. So Peter has the great significance. He is the rock over which you build the temple. That is why Peter became disabled, and so that people who long to have the church and they want the people to be honest going there, not greedy mammon, they should come and pick him up, dress him up and take him there. That means among the Gentile. Remember when Peter was young, he was objecting, hey, Paul, he's eating with Gentile and this and that, you know. He was still having that Jewish mentality. But when he became with the Holy Spirit, then that disappeared. And remember how the kosher, you know, all the thing came, ah, this is not kosher. He said, everything is kosher, eat it. So that means he was all that things which Peter used to have in the temple, they all disappeared from him. And he became open-minded. So that is what it is. Do not take gold or silver or copper for your beds. Remember, a person who went to cure a king of his sickness, gouts, in Iraq area. And when he had cured everyone, then when he was parting, the king wanted to give him a gift. He said, no. We have given our own possessions to God, and why should we take somebody else's possession? So these are forbidden. If you go preach gospel, if they give you to eat and sleep, that's enough. No money. No sack for the journey. No sack means that no food for your journey. Wherever you go, you will get food. Or a second tunic, sandals, a walking stick, or scrip. Now, in some of these versions, you know, they have missed the scrip. Scrip is letters, Bible. Bible is not allowed to be taken when you go on preaching tour, because the gospel gets written over your heart and not in ink on paper. Those who have using Bible, they thump Bible and they read passage, then the cross reference. They read that cross reference, then another cross reference. They don't understand what they are doing. They don't understand themselves, but the Bible, they keep on reading this thing, that thing. And they are happy that they have satisfied the person. The person isn't satisfied. So when I ask these theologians, you know, the John the Baptist, he baptized in water. He said, the one coming after me will baptize in Holy Spirit. Then I asked them, these university theologians and all these doctoral priests, then in whose name John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water? He never baptized a Gentile, a woman, or a Samaritan. They have no idea. It is written in the same passage where John the Baptist was baptizing in water. He said, don't you say that you have Abraham as your forefather? I can turn stones into sons of Abraham. But these theologians are the men of letters. They don't know what stone stand for. Stone is mean dumb-headed. Gushikoppa. Gushikoppa, the Jewish people call them. That is a stone-headed. We call it Pathar Dimag. That he can't understand anything. So scripts, the written Torah, written Torah, Old and the New Testament, the Bible, as gospel gets written over your own heart through logical reasoning. You have to do the logical reasoning yourself. Nobody can do it for you. So gospel is for your own self, individual basis. So that is why where the two or three people are gathered together in the name of Christ Jesus, then what they have in each then expresses himself. Then the other person criticizes or say, oh, this could not be like this, this is like this. Then they come to the right conclusion. They get logo out of it, out of these discussions. Through logical reasoning and not in ink on paper, the laborer deserves his keep in gospel treasures and not in mammon. So this is a corruption, you know, by these messianic Jews, so they can charge money or stay. And whatever town or village you enter, look for a worthy person who is the salt of earth, or has a conscience, you know, or be a son of Abraham in it. So, son of Abraham. Abraham was a noble man, and so are his sons. And stay there until you leave. As you enter a house, wish it peace. If the house is worthy, let your peace come upon it. If not, let your peace return to you, and do not throw pearls before swine, as the man in Gerasene region was doing. Remember, a person was doing preaching gospel. He was going to the roadside and telling that people, hey, look, 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 that our rabbi is a crook. He's doing wrong thing. Gospel is the time for gospel, no more for those dead letters, living gospel, which Jesus had preached in that area before. And people were, you know, the local rabbi was very angry. He said, hey, lock him in the silence of the graveyard. As I go to these churches and tell these dog hollow priests to get rid of you, Jesus died on the cross. What part you play in Christianity when the curtain of the holiest of holy was torn from top to bottom? Top means temple high priest to village rabbi, off you go. So where do you stand between man and God? They can't explain it. And they can't give your account as those rabbis used to give at Passover. So they are worse than those rabbis which Jesus got rid of by giving his own life at the cross. And they have no answer. When I call them that anybody who stands between man and God, he is Antichrist. And when I tell them you are Antichrist, they are furious, you know, but they can't hit me because it's a Britain, you know. If it was India, they would have slapped me left and right. So let your peace return to you, or do not throw pearls before swine, as the man in the Gerasene region was doing. And Jesus went to redeem him, you know. And he ended up locked in the silence of the graveyard. So they chained him up, lock him in the silence of the graveyard. But chains can't hold it when Jesus has set us free. Remember, Paul, when he was wounded and he was thrown into the prison, at night he started singing the praises of our Father, that he sent his Son, Christ Jesus, to set us free. And those prisoners who were listening to him carefully, then all their chain fell off. The walls surrounding them fell down. And they were free. So in the morning, the jail keeper, when he saw that, They are the prisoners, the walls have come down, the prisoners are free. He wanted to kill himself because the Roman will kill him, you know, for being irresponsible. Paul said, "No, no, don't do it. We are all here. Nobody has gone. We are all here. Nobody has run away." So then he looked after Paul. He came to his senses. And so gospel is for those who are sensible people, who are longing for gospel and loving God and not Satan, not cheating people, honest to the very bone. Gospel can rest in that heart and not those people who go for cheating. India is full of cheating. That is why Jesus said, as the lightning strikes in the east, that was Nanak who came in the east, flashes towards the west, but it doesn't shine there because people are greedy and crook. So it's shining towards the west, mainly people of the west will appreciate the knowledge we have in India, but not Indian will appreciate. So Jesus went to redeem him, this man, you know, in the Gerasim, who were locked in the silence of the graveyard, and told him not to throw pearls before swine. That's why he made 2,000 swine to drown in the lake. That is their fate. Those who don't listen to gospel, that is how they are going to die. And they are dying today. 1947 partition, it happened so. My father was preaching gospel. They called him heretic. They won't listen to him. Even such and such that if his acquaintance, you know, when he used to walk, and if he come across one, you know, he will try to slip away from him, so he doesn't have any communication with my father. Wanted to avoid him. And in 1947, they died like flies. I have written an article on that one, if somebody is interested. So, our Father, this is the golden age for earning your salvation. So work hard. Preach gospel. When you preach gospel, you are representing our Father. Then you are the Son of the Most High. And like Father, like Son. Our Father is eternal, and so are we eternal. So our Father God blesses you.